In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we thank you this hour.
Thank you,
Lord. Lord, because the hour has come for us to hear the word.
Yes,
Lord, the entrance of your word gives us life.
Amen.
Lord, I pray as men and women that will hear the sound of my voice this hour,
Amen.
Let them hear for the throne of grace.
Amen.
Let your word do us good.
Amen.
That in all your name alone be exalted. I come against every power of darkness that will try to hinder the word of God. I bind your cross and your pressure. Be bound in heaven. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Holy Spirit, take absolute control. That at the end of today, your name alone will be exalted.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Today I'll be speaking about every godly man are bishops of their home. Every godly man are bishops of their home. Hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
If you are a boy, you know you will become a man one day. This message also for you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you are a youth, you become a man someday. This message is for you. I pray may God give us understanding. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Open your Bible with me this hour and let us go to Ephesians chapter 5, verses 23 through 33. Ephesians chapter 5. We are talking about. If you don't know that, then you will fail your duty. I pray that men know their responsibility in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The reason why there are failures in hope is because men easily fail their duty. Because whatever happens in your family as a man, you are the one that God is going to call upon. We know that men are the head of the home. Even as Christ is the head of the church. Not just head by mouth, you must be able to do your responsibilities as a father. As a man in the house. Hallelujah. In Genesis chapter 3, from verses 9 to 11, Adam fell. And God was looking for Adam. He was not looking for him. The Bible said that God was saying, Adam, where are you? So man, where are you? Whether you are a pastor, whether you are a bishop, whether you are a deacon, whether you are an elder, whether you are a businessman, as long as you are a Christian man, as long as you are a Christian father, as long as you are a child of God, a man that fears the Lord, you are a bishop of your home. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Therefore, you will be able to give account of your household to God. God said, Adam, where are you? Adam said, I hide myself. Adam, why are you hiding yourself? He said, because he was naked. I pray that every man that are naked, that God will clothe them back in the name of Jesus. Many men are naked today because they don't know their responsibility. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. They are naked today because they are not performing their duty as a man. This time, many people wake up in the morning, it is job. Coming back late, everybody are sleeping. Wake up the next day, it is job. It is good to work, but it's also good to perform our responsibility as fathers in the home. Praise the Lord. It is very important. The women cannot do it alone. There's a role of a father. Whenever the woman is telling the children, I will report you to your daddy when he comes back, that child will adjust. Praise the Lord. Therefore, men must be concerned about their wife, about their children. Whatever is happening in our home, we must be concerned. Not only to just bring money for feeding, no. Hallelujah.
Yes,
our attention is needed as men. Today, all over the world, people are saying, Seventh May Day, there is nothing like celebration in the Word of God. You as a man, are you performing your duty in your home? It's a day or time for sober reflection. Am I doing what I'm supposed to do as a man? You can be a pastor in the church and fail at home. You can be a bishop of churches and fail at home. Hallelujah. May God not let that be our portion. In the mighty name of Jesus. Therefore, attention of the man as a godly father, as a child of God, is needed in the home. We must be able to know what is happening with our children. We must be able to know what is happening with our wife. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Most men today, even preachers, their children dressed like unbelievers. They don't care. They keep on preaching to others. We must be able to preach to our wife and children. We must be able to put them in position before we preach to others. May God give us the grace.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible makes it clear that men are the head of the home. Not just head by mouth, by action, by doing. It's supposed to be so. As a man, you must have time to be able to teach your children the Word of God. As a man, you must be able to have time to teach your family how to fast and pray. As a man, you need to make time to correct your household. Glory be to God.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
It is good to put money in the table every day, but it's also good because there's something money cannot buy. Attention of a man is needed in the home. Hallelujah. You can be a preacher preaching all over your world, but there is fire in your home. It's not supposed to be so. The reason why we are having that voice and separation today is because the man failed to perform his duty. Hallelujah. Your wife is not married to money. Your wife is married to you. Your wife is not married to the children. Your wife is married to you. Therefore, your attention is needed. Wherever you are, all over your world, hearing the sound of my voice this afternoon, you have to ask yourself, am I performing my duty as a man, as a godly father, as a father that fears the Lord? Remember your exemplary life, your children will follow. Hallelujah. It is not enough to shout, but in action. Amen and amen.
Amen.
So as a man, we need to put things in order in our home. A man must be able to know the Word of God and bring his family and teach them the Word of God. But a man that is a bishop of his home, who does not read the Bible morning, afternoon, evening, what do you have to show and what do you teach? It is what you know you are going to give. Today, most of the women are doing the role of a man because the man has failed their duty. I pray that God will clothe men back out of their nakedness in the mighty name of Jesus. Man is the head of the house. It's not enough for we to say we are the head of the house. Are you performing your duty as a head? Do you set time for prayer in the house? Do you set time for fasting in the house? As a man, you need to be done. Some men took their business more than their family. If you are doing this, you already failed. Traveling here to another country, another, it's good to travel, but you must make time to know what is happening in your household. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When a man is talking at home, it's different from where the wife is talking. The children mostly obey the man than their mother that they are used to every time. Hallelujah. That is why when the woman says, I will report it to your daddy, every children they will adjust. Because they know that daddy will give us punishment, daddy will not take it easy. But we must not be a man that when our wife complains about the children, we just ignore. No. Hallelujah. We must address the matter. But if you are not a man, responsibility. How are you going to address the matter? I pray before things get wrong in our home, may we know who we are as men all over the whole world, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
A man that fears God will not tell his wife not to serve God. Because God is your head, as your head of your home. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
A man that fears God will not tell his wife, carry Jesus out of my house. No. A man that fears God must not restrict his wife from serving the Lord. That is the only area where women will never obey any man that wants to take you out of God. Hallelujah. It is not possible. Any man that wants to take his wife and children out of God, such man will never be obeyed. Because if you want your family to obey you, you have to obey God. Hallelujah. We must be men that have the fear of God in our life. We must be men that are godly in our character. We must be men that are not pretending. God will help us and strengthen us in the mighty name of Jesus. We have read clearly say that men are the head. That is true. But are you performing the duty of man in your house? Anna, where are you? We will give account of how we rule our family to God. As a man, God will ask us. It shall be required. I pray today that every home that there is trouble, that God will bring peace back.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
A man will be able to look at a right eye and know when things is wrong. A man will be able to look at the children's eyes and know when things is wrong. But when your attention is not there, when it is needed, you can't be able to amend it. Praise the Lord. There are things that money cannot solve. Hallelujah. Our attention, money cannot solve that in our family. May God help us in every area. Men are naked, that God will clothe them back. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let us go to the book of quickly, let's go to Genesis chapter 18. Genesis 18, 17 to 19. Every godly man are bishops of their home. As a man, you are the head of your house. For how are you ruling your house? Are you able to put this in order? Because God will ask you, where are thou? Genesis chapter 18. Let's look at 17 and 19. If you are there, say amen quickly. And the Lord said, shall I hide from Abraham the thing which I do? Shall I hide from Abraham the thing which I do? See that Abraham shall surely become a great and mighty nation, and all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him. For I know him, that he will command his children and his household after me. And they shall walk and keep my ways, to do justice and judgment, that the Lord may bring upon Abraham that which he has spoken of him. Can God look at us and say, I know you, as a man, that you are able to command your household to walk after him? Do you have the fear of God as a man? You want everybody to respect you as a man. You want your wife and children to respect you as a man. But do you have the fear of God? God is saying here, yeah, I know that Abraham will command his household. He will command them to walk after my stature. Beloved brethren, what are you laying down for your children? Is it wacth? It's good. But what of presenting Jesus to them? Do your children know Jesus through you? Hallelujah. Do your children see Jesus in you? In your character, at home, as a father. There are some men, you still drink secretly, when your children are coming, you hide them. You think that they are not seeing. They may see you, but they cannot talk. That is the godly character. I pray may God deliver the men in the mighty name of Jesus. Here he says, I know that Abraham will command his children. With God said, I know that you will command. match your children. Even you can be a bishop in the church, pretending all is okay, but at home there is fire. It is good. So men dress every time coming to church, they use the same cloth, husband and wife, pretending that everything is okay, but there is fire at home. I pray that God will make us men to know our role.
Amen.
So that there will be peace in the house in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
The reason why some men are running at home is because they are not putting the home in order. Home become a fire for you. I pray we should be able to come back to our responsibility in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God said, I know Abraham. He will command his children. Are you commanding your children to walk in the way of God? Or are you commanding your children to dress like unbeliever? Are you commanding your wife to dress like unbeliever? Because you are a man, you will tell your woman, your wife to dress like Jezebel. It is wrong. Hallelujah.
Yes,
a man must have the fear of God. Because God is your own head. We must not lead our wife to astray. We must not say, because I'm your husband, you must do what I say by leading that woman to her. May God deliver such men in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are talking about every godly man are bishops of their home. Every godly man are bishops of their home. Therefore, you must have the fear of God to be able to bring your family to Jesus. Because God will ask you, how did you rule your home? Like he asked Adam, Adam, where are you? God does not take excuses. Amen.
Amen.
God does not respond to excuses. But God wants us to obey him. You as a man of the house, if you are obeying God, then your family will also obey you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I know Abraham, he will command his children to walk in my ways and in my statutes. May God give us the grace. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 8. Men are bishops of their home. Whether you are a pastor, whether you are an evangelist, whether you are a pope, whosoever you are a bishop of your home as a man. Therefore, your responsibility needs to be met as a father in the house. 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 8. 1 Timothy 5, 8. Here it says, but if any provide not for his own, and especially for those of his own house, he has denied their faith and is worse than infidel. A father must be able to provide for the house. A father must be able to have a job. A father must not be sleeping when others are working. Hallelujah.
Yes,
manna don't fall from heaven anymore. Amen.
Amen.
A father must rise to go and look for a job to make sure you're able to provide for your household. Glory be to God. A father must not be complaining there's no job anywhere. He must go out there and look for a job. As you are a child of God, God will give you a job to feed your family.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
If any man provide not, it's worse than infidel. God are making the head. It's not just by mouth. You will go out there and look for job that will glorify God. Then you need that job to feed your family. A father that is a thief has missed it already. May God give us the grace.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Therefore, as a man of the house, you must be able to provide for the need of your family. You must be able to see that your family is well cared for. You have to show your coat according to your size. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
As a child of God, you must not live exorbitantly. You must not do what the world people are doing. Let your family know the size of your pocket. Don't be proud. Let them know what you are earning. Don't hide from your wife your salary. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If your wife do not know your salary, she may be demanding more than what you are earning. Let her know your salary. Stop keeping secrets in that area. My wife at all. Hallelujah. Amen. Men should be able to reason with their wife. Communication is important. Where communication is lacking in the family, there will be trouble. Then they will be suspicious. Praise the Lord. Where communication is lacking at all, there is trouble. We need to be able to open up to our spouse. As a father, you must open up to your wife and children. You must not be keeping secrets from them. Let there be communication flow. Tell your wife what is in your mind. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God. When this is done, then there will be peace at home. God will give us the grace
Amen.
To run this race and give account of our children to God in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We must be able to provide for our household. If anyone is not able, it's worse than an infidel. May that not be your portion.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Communication is important. Amen. Easily forgiveness is important as a man. No matter what happened as a man, you must quickly know that you are a child of God. There are some preachers, they left home with quarrel and even go to the church and be preaching. You are giving the people poison. You don't supposed to do that. You need to settle your house. God is watching. You need to settle your house before you feed the flock of Jesus Christ. Any pastor that is not able to pastor his own house is worse than infidel. May there not be our portion.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
There are pastors that are still fighting at home. But when you come to church, you pretend everything are okay. It doesn't supposed to be so. As the head, you must have the fear of God. May God bring back the fear upon men in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
1 Timothy chapter 3. 1 Timothy chapter 3. Let us see 2 and 4. Every godly man are bishops of their home. You are the head of your house. Therefore, you must perform your responsibility at home. You must be able to provide for your household. 1 Timothy chapter 3, let us read from 2. A bishop then must be blameless, husband of one wife, vigilant, sober, good behavior, given to hospitality, able to teach. As a bishop of your home, you must be blameless. You must be blameless. You must be blameless. You must be a husband of one wife. There is no Christian man that will dream of marrying second wife. Marriage is for life. Till death do you part. That is what the God is saying. That is what the Bible is telling us. Hallelujah. The Bible said, from the beginning, God made a husband and wife. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You must be a husband of one wife. That is why that a godly father, you don't need to mingle with men that can lead you astray. There are some evil men that will give you evil counsel that will lead you astray. Run from such people. Evil communication corrupts good manner. There are Christian men that are still having girlfriends outside. May God deliver them.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Husband of one wife. Don't tell me provided you are able to provide for them. No. Husband of one wife. That is what the Bible is saying. As long as your wife is alive, you are tied to that woman. Till death do you part. Hallelujah. There are many Christian men that are flirting around today. I pray that they repent from every sin.
Amen.
So that they come back to Christ in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says, must be vigilant, sober, of good behavior. As a child of God, as a man, as a bishop of your house, you must have good behavior. You must have good character. You must not be shared to your family. God said, I know your heart. He will command his family to walk according to my steps. That is how it's supposed to be. said, not given to wine, not striker, not greedy, not fitting love, but patience, not brutal, not covetous. A Christian father must have good character. Amen.
Amen.
You must not bring shame to the Lord, and you must not bring shame to your family. I pray, whatsoever that will bring shame to your family, that God will take away in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You must have a fear of God. You must have time out to be able to go to God, intercede on behalf of your family. Hallelujah. If you want to pray for your wife and children, if you want to bring them to the throne of God, and God will always answer you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Therefore, a godly father must not take advice from unbeliever. Unbeliever will tell you how they are getting away, but you must not. That is why a godly father must not be a boy. You become a boy when you are taking advice from your family. The Bible says a man will leave his father and his mother. Most men are not leaving their father and their mother. They are still attached. Whatever happened in your family, you must follow your father and your mother. It's not supposed to be so. If that is happening, you are a boy and not yet a man. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Your father, who is a believer, will be giving you counsel. You are not yet a man. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You should have the fear of God as a man and be able to walk the way that you please God. That's how supposed to be. As a bishop of your family, you must be able to put this in order. Hallelujah.
Yes,
you must be able to advise your wife and children to study the Bible. You must be able to advise your wife and children to read. If they are seeing you doing it, they will follow. Your exemplary life is speaking louder than you talking. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Not as a father, you don't have time to study the Bible. You don't have time to even read. You don't have time to pray. The children cannot see you pray one time. They can't even see you fasting. Every day it is hard to eat. Brethren, you must be able to know that that will not be thus to God. You must be able to do the right thing in the mighty name of Jesus. There are times you can be able to go on fasting. The family will want to know that daddy is waiting upon the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And God will give us the grace to run this race in the mighty name of Jesus. We must be able to provide for our family. We must be able to know our duty and perform it at home in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us quickly go to 1 Peter 3. 1 Peter 3, 7. 1 Peter 3, 7. 1 Peter 3, 7. A godly man are bishops of their home. You are a bishop of your home. You are the head of your house. Therefore, you must live by example, not just by talking. Let your family see you living a life that pleases God. That is how it's supposed to be. 1 Peter 3, 7. Let's open our Bible quickly. He says, likewise, your husband, dwell with them and got to knowledge. Give you honor to the wife, as unto a weaker vessel, and as be held together of the grace of life, that your prayer be not hindered. Your prayer as a man can be hindered if you are not playing your role at home. You may be saying, where are you, where is this getting wrong? As a man, if you don't do what you're supposed to do at home, your prayer can be hindered. Dwell with them as a weaker vessel. You should know that your wife is a weaker vessel. That's what the Bible says. Some men still beat their wife. When you are doing this, you are not a child of God at all. You are a child of the devil. Hallelujah.
Yes,
a godly child of God cannot raise up his hand against his wife, no matter what. What of his rapture happened at that time, he will go to hell. Hallelujah. That your prayer may not be hindered. If you are a godly man and you are maltreating your wife and children, your prayer can be hindered. Your prayer can be hindered. If you are cheating upon your wife, your prayer can be hindered. If you are lying to your wife, your prayer can be hindered. If you are not doing your responsibility, your prayer can be hindered. Hallelujah. If you are not at peace with your wife, your prayer can be hindered. When your prayer is hindered, there will be trouble in the home. Hallelujah. A godly man, you are a bishop of your home. So ask yourself a question. Am I a godly man at home? Am I a bishop of my home? Or is it by mercy? Do I have time for my wife and children? Pastors preaching every now and then, traveling up and down. You must not neglect your family. The most time given to your own wife and children, your attention is also needed. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Not when your children are dying and crying at home and you are busy ministering to other people. It is good to travel and minister up and down, but your family must be treated in a way that God will not hinder your prayer. Hallelujah. Very important. Stop keeping secret for your wife. Your telephone is ringing, your wife has the right to pick that telephone. Some men can title women's name in their telephone, putting men's name there so that your wife will not know. Some men can put lock on their phone that their wife cannot be able to operate their phone. Why? If you are doing that, something is wrong. Some men will be in the bedroom. When your phone rings, you run downstairs because your secret will be exposed. I pray may God deliver such ones. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
If your wife don't know your pin number as a man, you are hiding something. And it's not good to decide on God. Hallelujah.
Yes,
that your prayer may not be hindered. Not by shouting, I'm a man. But are you taking care of your responsibility as a man? There are wicked vessels, that's what we may have. So you must understand and nourish them and change them. May God give us the grace.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are talking about every godly man are bishops of their home. If you don't want your prayer to be hindered, you must be able to dwell with your wife, with your children. Make peace with them always, so that your prayer may not be hindered. Most men are getting it wrong. They're going to ask themselves, I'm not committing sin, but are you treating your wife in a bad way, that she cannot complain, she cannot talk, she endure? Do you think God is not watching? Because of that, your prayer can be hindered. This is why it is important as a man, you must be able to treat your wife like you treat yourself. May God give us the grace.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Colossians chapter 3, verse 19, quickly. Colossians chapter 3, verse 19. Colossians chapter 3, verse 19. Are you a godly father? Are you a man that fears the Lord? If you are, you have to have a good character in you. Colossians chapter 3, verse 19. Husbands, love your wives and be not bitter against them. Husband, love your wife and be not bitter against them. So men, if your wife offends you and say, I'm sorry, you will not accept. So men, when your wife offends you, you refuse to eat. It is not the character of a man that fear God. So men, when your wife offends you, you go to bed without talking to her. It is not the character of God. Even pastors are practicing this evil character. I pray, may God clothe everyone that is naked in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, don't be bitter with them. Don't be bitter with them. A man of God was going to hell. Why? Because the wife slapped him. And the wife come and said, my husband, I am sorry. But the man refuses to forgive. We are not telling the women to slap their husband, but whatsoever happened at home, always try to forgive. Hallelujah. Because God does not entertain excuses. This man of God was going to hell because he refuses to accept the apology of the wife. Don't be bitter with your wife. Hallelujah. Try to serve in your heart with your wife. Know that you and your wife are one. Glory be to God. Don't be bitter with your wife. That your prayer may not be hindered. Your prayer can be hindered if you are having a bad character towards your wife and children. It is very wrong. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. The same Colossians 3, let us look at 21. It says, fathers, provoke not your children to anger, lest they be discouraged. Provoke not your children to anger. Don't be a lion at home. Amen. You must be able to have a time to play with your children. You must have a time to sit down with them. You must have a time to even be among them when they are talking, pretending that you are not hearing, just be listening. Then you shall hear their conversation. Don't be a man when you are coming and holding everybody wrong from you. You are not a lion, you are a father. Hallelujah. We will not expect when God is calling us to be running away from Him. No. Don't be the man when you are parking your car outside. They say, He has come. Trouble has come. No. It's not supposed to be so. When Jesus in the family, happy, happy, oh, happy, happy, oh.
Is your hand defiled? If your hand is defiled, you have failed.
If your heart is defiled, your prayer will be hindered. Hallelujah. The Bible says, lift up holy hands. That hands that you are lifting up, are they still holy? Are they still pure? Or do you use bile at work to defraud others? When you do that, your hands are no more pure. Hallelujah. May God give us the grace.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lift up your holy hands. Your hands must be holy. Your hands must be clean. Your hands must be pure. May God give us the grace to run this race as godly fathers in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Enough of celebration in the church. Things of the world, we are bringing them to the church. We need to know as men that we must know our responsibility. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Some men use your body to maltreat your wife. You deny your wife your body, you are committing sin. Because the Bible says the body belongs to your wife. Hallelujah. Because you have misunderstanding, you now want to punish your wife with your body. Because you know, your wife is a Christian, she will not go and mess up. Now you use your body to try to retaliate. It is wrong. If you do that, you are walking towards hell. Hallelujah. Every godly man are bishops of their home. Your character must show a character of a bishop, of a leader. Hallelujah. Not by shouting, but by how you relate. Your family must be first before any other thing. If you fail at home, you have failed in everywhere you go. May God let us pray at home.
Amen.
May God restore us.
Amen.
As men that are falling, may God bring them back to the faith.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Husband, you are the head of your home. No. A godly husband will not tell the wife not to go and serve God where they are preaching holiness and righteousness. When something is happening, your wife is supposed to know about you. You must relate to your wife how you go to work. If anything go wrong, tell your wife. Don't hide secret from your wife. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Amen and amen.
Amen.
We are talking about godly father. If you are a boy, you are a young man, you become a man one day. And I pray that this message will not do us evil. It will do us good in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You must play your responsibility as a father.
Amen.
You must show example.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You must be able to take your family first. You must want to provide for your household. Try not to be a disgrace to your family. Not to be shame to your family. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Money on the table is not enough. But your attention is needed at home. Teach your children how to fear God. Teach them the way of God. Like God said, I know Abraham. He will command his children to walk after me. The best thing a father can leave behind is the word of God for the children. Train up the child in the way we go, that where him or her is old, she or he will not depart. This is a duty of a man. Whereby the man has failed, that is where women are picking up. It also goes to be so. If you are still the head of your home, you must be able to teach your children the fear of God, the word of God, how to pray, how to read the Bible. Tell them that the way of God is the right way. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
You cannot be at home. Your wife is playing the role. That means you have just put down yourself and allow your wife to be the head. It's not supposed to be so as a man. We know you want to go to job, but there must be some time you put things in order. When there is question from the Bible, we're supposed to ask our Father, our godly Father. Daddy, you can be a red if you don't understand. You put light into it. But you that does not read your Bible, what answer are you going to give? So men are still boys because you take advice from your friend and from your father who is a believer and from mother who is a believer. You are still a boy. You have not yet left your father and your mother. May God restore men back to their responsibility. in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
No matter what your wife is doing, no matter what your children are doing, take them in prayer. Pray. Isaac entreat the Lord for the wife. Pray. Pray. Hallelujah. Present your family to God. Make a time. Have a quiet time. Make a time to present your children. Look at what Job was saying. Job said, I don't know whether any of my children are cursing God. Therefore, he do proper sacrifices on behalf of the children. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The children whom God has given to us, we are going to give account again to God. May God help us to play our role.
Amen.
That we will not lead our children to hell. If you are a godly father, you can't teach your children to be children that are guests to be wearing trousers because it's not biblical. It is not in the Bible. You can't teach your children that are guests to be wearing tight, showing their body as young as they are growing up. It is not in the Bible. You must want to teach your wife and your children to be able to clothe their body properly as a godly children of God. That people will see and say, oh, to God be the glory. Hallelujah. If your father is still by trousers for your children, you are leading them to hell. May God deliver those fathers. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let your children as they are growing up know that the girls are supposed to dress like a woman. They are not man. They must be different. May God give us the grace. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because if they are not taught from youth, when they grow up, it will be hard. That is why you must play a role at home as a father. As a father that is going to bring the children up in holiness and righteousness. In the fear of God. We are going to rise on our feet and we are going to pray. Anywhere you are falling as a father, that God will restore you. Not just saying, I'm the head of the house, beating your wife. The Bible says when you scratch your body, if it pains you, you know that that is how it is. When you scratch your wife's body, you must be able to know and do what you know it is good for yourself. Also do that for your wife and children. You must take your responsibility at home as a father. You must give time, attention for your children and your wife. Not outside, but your home. So men can advise people outside, but they cannot advise their family. Open your mouth and talk to God. Open your mouth and talk to God. Open your mouth and talk to God.